I'm going to show you, start from finish, my process of actually making music. Because it's one thing me showing you it and telling you, oh, you can do this. But now I'm going to make a song. The cameras are going to be rolling. And I'm going to make a song. I've got nothing planned at all. I'm just going to, yeah, see what happens. It could be really good, could be awful. But you get to see the process that I do when making music. So first of all, let's go through a few things to do before you even start music. Make sure your area is clean. Because if it's dirty, it will stress you out. Right? It stresses me out anyway. Another thing, this is really important, get your phone out, okay? Right, make sure it's on airport mode, okay? Do not want anyone calling you at all, okay? So, super important. Put it in your pocket, don't have it out. So if it's out, you'll be tempted to look at it. You look at social media messages or emails or whatnot. Another thing is, not the best for you, but I like to have a cup of coffee. Actually got a flask of coffee, so I can top it up so I don't actually have to leave the seat. It's quite good. Another thing is, I've got some mixed nuts, so I can have some of these with a bit of energy, keep it going, try and keep it moderately healthy. Coffee's not the best, I know, but got to do what you got to do, I suppose. So that's it, doing my desk. I've got camera here. Another camera over here, third camera over here, and the MIDI controller. So you can see my fingers what I'm typing. Also got iMac over here recording the microphone, which is up here just out of view. So I'm actually using my MacBook. As I know, most of you won't be using an iMac to do Logic Pro. Most of you will be using your MacBook. So I've got screen recording software, so you can see what I'm doing on the screen like this. Whee! Right, we might receive the Death Wheel, the Wheel of Doom. Because this is quite an old MacBook. It's time to upgrade, but I've got so many cool little synths and stuff on here. I just haven't bothered to swap it over yet. But today, I would just be using the stuff that you get with Logic Pro 10. So I've got a lot of external synths, a lot of internal synths, extra loops, that kind of thing. Won't be using any of that, just the stuff in Logic Pro 10, which, to be honest, it does kind of limit me a bit. Because I do use a lot of other manufactured synthesizers and loop samples and stuff like that. But as this is a Logic Pro 10 course, I'm just going to use the stuff. Logic Pro. Okay, so let's get stuff going. What is being so slow? Right. Force quit does sometimes happen. So if you do get that Wheel of Doom, something's not working, force quit. I believe it's because I've got screen recording software going on. It's just been a bit slow. Doesn't really like me. But I hope you started to make your own music by now. Hope you got some good ideas. Go through the course again if you get stuck on anything. And yeah, just keep thinking of new ideas and keep pushing yourself, really. That's the main thing. Try and be creative and also try and collaborate with as many people as possible. So if you're just doing it yourself, you're going to get stuck in that trap of just doing the same thing over and over again. If you collaborate with new people and new ideas, and obviously just try and educate yourself as much as possible, you'll kind of expand your horizon of song ideas, really. You just realise there's new things you can do. Okay, so here's a previous project I was working on. As you can see, there's quite a few tracks going on there. I actually had to freeze some of the tracks because Logic was crashing, which basically means it turns off some of the effects so we can go a bit more. So this is a... it's a bit messy at the moment, but this is one in progress. But for now, so see, like a 10 minute piece. Let's start with a new track and have it nice and clean. Let's just close this. Don't save it. As I said before, I have nothing planned at all. I don't know what I'm going to do. But let's just see what happens. So let's get rid of this inspector, clean up a bit. Okay, so we've got the classic electric piano here. Let's put my headphones on so I can hear what's going on, okay? Yep, so we've got the MIDI controller working. I normally like to start with drums a lot of the time. So fill in there, start with drum kit, get a nice drum groove going. There we go. Get a nice simple beat going. Dun, 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 dun. So that's about the tempo I've got. It's a nice little handy app you can get on your smartphone. You can do it Logic, but it's a little bit simpler doing it on the app. It's like bump, 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 bump. Just get a tap tempo and like start it. So it was bump, 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 bump. Bum 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 bum. Let's get away. Dun 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 dun. Say it's 128. Say it's 122. So it's not far off where I was, to be fair. Let's get a little loop going. I'm probably gonna change the sound to something else, you know. So it's 8-bar loop. Oh, that's not it. 8-bar loop. It's a bit distracting, this. Let's close this. Okay, then just, let's just see, let's just set it going. Just see what I get. So, 2, 3, 4. I'm not happy with that. Let's start. I want it longer than that. So, count him. So, there's none. I don't want that. I want a bar of counting so I know what's going on. 1, 2, 3. Right, so we've got this groove. Let's open it up. It's pretty much in time, it's not far off, to be fair. So, right, let's quantize this. Boom. Now we should have a little cheeky groove going. See what it sounds like. So it's missed the first kick. Right, so first of all, it missed the first kick and the hi-hat. So let's get, I want quite a hard one, so let's get this one, drag it over. Kick over. At the end, there's some terrible stuff going on. Right, let's see what it sounds like. No. Right. Just try the end, loop that, 1, 2, 3, yeah, there we go. Right, so we've got a little loop going. It's not amazing, but for now, we'll leave it like that. I really don't want a Bluebird kit. I want something a little bit more, I'm just feeling something a little bit more electronic. Let's go for Fizzy Beats. I don't actually know what this sounds like, to be honest. It sounds cool, Fizzy Beats. So it sounds like. Yeah, no. Grimy. It's pretty retro. Gritty funk. Gritty funk. Oh, it is pretty gritty. Indie disco. Right, what we got? Yeah. Right. Let's leave it on that for a bit. Right, one thing I always like to do. Copy that over. Okay, so, right, so let's go on this. Find the snares, which is obviously the D. Right, boom. I don't delete, I normally keep them just in case. So, mute tool, mute it, there we go. And drag this over. Right, it's all muted, right? And mute these. Get these back again. Back again. There we go. Mute it. So we've got the snare still. Because I'm feeling like a big reverberated snare already. Let's get rid of this shit. Okay, so let's. Right, so we've got the snares going there. Okay. Let's open this up in a new window. Let's just put Big Space Designer on. Kind of a bit too much. I reckon just send it to a bus. The bus it. It's five. Then we can control it a little bit more. Like that. Like this one. See ya. Boom. Whack it on. Okay. Put a bit of, come on. And then, oh yeah. That's nice. Turn it down a bit. Maybe even do a little bit of delay. Might be nice and cheeky. Let's get delay designer open. See what we get here. That could work for a breakdown. Yeah. I like it, yeah. That's cool. Alright, we've got that going. It's pretty groovy. Got a bass line going. Sick. What you've got here? No, you want a synth bass. I normally use my own presets, so go from scratch a little bit. Whoa! But we've got to do it. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, something like that. Let's get this groove going. And let's loop it over. I got a few little ideas. I got boom, boom, kind of funky stuff. Let's keep it going. See what we get. Boom, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, I've got the groove, let's do it properly now. 2, 3, 4. That's it, yeah, something like that. Right, so it's pretty good. Let's quantize it in. Whoa. Loop on, see what it sounds like. Little mistake there. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Right, so we've got that going. Maybe just swing it a little bit. See what we got here. I don't seem to do anything. Let's try one of these swings. I don't seem to do anything. Right, what's with the swings? There we go. Right. This bit not swung. Not that one. I don't know if it needs swinging, to be fair. No idea. Yeah, I'm liking that. Let's get that groove going. That little funky groove. Get a few loops over, and then I think we should automate this bass synth because it's a little boring to start with. So let's see what we've got on the synth. This is ES2, and it's got a phaser on it. Open up ES2. Let's check the cameras for a sec. Make sure we're rolling still. Yeah, cool. Sorry, so filter, obviously. Yeah. So that is cut off. Kind of a, yeah, cut off. We can build it up, like. Got distortion. That's good. Flanger, yeah. 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 I like that. Got a little cheeky little octa thing going on. Keep that going. So that was just grooving around there. If you know your harmony, C minor. So let's get a little cheeky little synth, a little more keyboard style. So classics, see what we got here. Octave up. Sounds a little meh. Not like that one. Let's get the ES. I like the ES2. Let's get that up and see what we've got. We've got going on there. So that's retro synth. Not too happy with that. ES2. What we got? Put that down. Maybe I could get like a pad. Nice. Got some nice chords going. Thank you. got those chords. We've got C minor, G minor, A flat major. 2, 3, 4. Could be, we can do something with it. It's not terrible, but I'm not happy with it in the context there. Just straighten these up. But, right. I reckon I can make like a nice build up with that. So let's move this over. Copy this stuff. Right, so we'll have to change stuff around. Then we like to color code it. So this one, I'm gonna change this now. So let's change it to red. Now that's a different section, so I don't get lost. So this is the bass part. Right there, bit at the end. So it's this bit. Over. This bit. I'm feeling something with this. We can do something with this. So I can just do this as well. Like that. If you think there's too many little bits rolling around, getting the glue. Glue it together. I like to have mute on the right hand button normally. Just so I can try new ideas and mute them and see what it sounds like. Right, so we've got this going. I'm feeling not having this bass coming for a while. And then, arrangement. It's all about arrangement, really. Right, so we've got the snare. No snare for a while. Bye-bye. Let's just make this really simple. Just get rid of a color. Get rid of like, all the hats and stuff. And just a kick. Nice and simple. Eat it. We'll leave the double at the end, see what that sounds like. Right, feeling this. I feel like this is going to work. No. No, I'll be right. Keep it simple, man. No pissing around with this. Simple, 4-4. It's all right now. It's all about. It's really simple. I want it nice, elegant. None of this. Meh. That makes sense. Start again. Here we go. Oh no. Wheel of Doom. Okay. This is when you've got something good going on as well. Just comes up. Just kills you, man. But allows you time to top up your drink. So it's not always a waste. Wait for the Wheel of Doom to run its course. But this happens, especially if you've got an older map like this and you're running other programs that I normally do. Application not responding, but it's part of the game. It's quit, this can happen, so I don't want to be shiny. Right. Just open up it up again. Okay. So file. Worst comes to worst. Do it again, but remember I should have done that. Why did I forget? Got to save. So now I'm gonna save it, okay? Call it right. Don't call it your name. Call it demo song. Yeah, you need to put it in a different kind of folder, really. So you, then you date it. You put it. Like I said before. Make sure you put in the hard drive, don't just keep on logic. But I sort all my songs after and put them month by month, so. Say for example, I've done 10 songs that month. I have to find these, by the way, they keep me going, these are good. You don't feel guilty about eating them, because, yeah. Whole nuts. Right, where were we? I was looking for a plucked bass sound. I was getting into it then, I was feeling it and cut me off. Ambient pluck strings. This was the killer. It's done it again. So for some reason, it's not liking me today. MIDI controller, it's not my usual MIDI controller. As I killed it. So when stuff like this happens, it's quit. Application not responding. But it can happen. It's annoying really because you're kind of getting that creative flow. And then you get some technical mooby jooby like this comes along and just kills it. But it's part of the game. It's just what happens. So like this. Looks like the song does not exist. So I've got to find it. Sort these cameras out. If you hold on a minute. Right. Okay, I just had to sort out some of the cameras. Demo song Tom, here we go. So if you're saving an external hard drive, that's what I always like to do. Demo song Tom. Logic has an autosave version of this project. Yeah, so I've already saved. See what that looks like. Bring it up. Okay, for some reason, I didn't really like me doing a plucked bass sound. I'm gonna try Asian pluck strings. Right. Now we've got something, but this happens, you can't pretend it doesn't. It does. When you start making bigger projects, then you get system overload. OK? Okay, no more of these nuts are distracting me. Okay, we get system overload, but now, see what we got. That sounds like death. For some reason, it's changed the pad. Luckily, I remembered it was there. It was the first one. Synthesizers, pad. Oh, no, it was on ES2. It was an ES2, I remember though. Right, let's get ES2 up. I don't know what it's playing at. Synth pads. There we go. Got something cooking now. Okay, right. I think I can finger something here. Sit record and start. I don't like this bass line now, it's too meh. Put it there, might come back to it, but more likely scrap. Right, we do the mistake like that. You know what to do, control Z. Cool. So I just want this. It's a nice part, it's going. Yeah. That's the thing when you're building songs like this, you can just develop. Like, you don't know what's going to happen. I thought I was going to use that part, and evidently I don't want to use it. But there's a couple of nice bits in here. Now that, no. That can kind of work. There, so 21 to 17. Right. Let's quantize it. Cheeky. 21 to 17. So it's, I'll let's do this now and again. It's a bit of a pet ahead. There's this bit here. I think that sounded nice. So let's going. I was liking that delay we did before on the drums. Let's see what that sounds like. So it was delay design, that was this one, I remember. Oh, it was bus, wasn't it? Oh, let's send it to the bus. Bus 5. That could have some magic. See what it sounds like. Might be terrible, might be good. Thank you. Save it, because you never know when it might go. I will not be singing on this, as you probably just noticed. It's getting some flavour. It's getting something. I'm feeling double up. Soundscape. Ooh. Strings. Sorry, I'm feeling double up that part. Let's see what it sounds like. Might be cheeky. Obviously not the one with the automated. I'll probably get rid of that distortion, but a bit crusher, but it's been a little experimental. Ugh. Let's go back to the S2. We're doing well with that. It's more like it. Yeah. Yeah. Then we can automate the cut. That's, yeah, this bit, right? New ideas, boom. Get rid of that one with a silly bit crusher. Okay, so it's not coming in for a while. This is just gonna be this little cheeky one. And make the cut.
Thank you.
drum kit sounds terrible. So that's Will of Doom, obviously. Gives you a minute to sit back and enjoy your drink. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to separate the kick, the hats, and the snare, and I want the kick like fall to the floor, driving beat for this song. I've kind of changed direction. Originally it was kind of a funk song, but now I'm feeling more electronic dance song, really. So that should, should kind of work, hopefully. Let's get back in it. So this one is going to be hats. So I've got kick. Oh, I've got the kick. This one's obviously a snare, just so we don't get too confused, so we know what's going on. Let's colour code these as well. Right, it's a different colour now, just so we know the hat, the snare is a blue, kick's green, drag it down. Right, so just the hat's the kick. See ya. I want that. So there's a mute tool. So it's just the hats now. So we've got hats. Something going on. Colour as well. It's purple. Right, I want the four to the floor to continue. But I like the hats we were playing before. So at that point, I'd say the hats can come in. Keep that groove going. And then bring the snare in there. Kicks obviously keep it going. See what we got going. Okay, keep this lot on the rise. But I think we're getting somewhere. It's a build up kind of before the main song starts. So let's just hear what it sounds like now. I need to sort this synth out. It's so weak. Alright. I need to find where the cutoff automation is. So that's what we need to do. Go back to the ES2. There, cutoff. And it's cutoff. But there's two different cutoffs. It's kind of blended to this one. So now it's on cutoff. This looks like I've blended it to cutoff 2, which is a bit daft. Let's have a look. So it seems like global. So yeah, sometimes I think they're the synths well, but not as well as you thought. There we go, it's called bypass filter for some reason. But that just seems to switch on and off. I was wrong. Right, but it's what happens. Sometimes it's not perfect. Sometimes you can't find everything you want, but try and error a lot of it. MMF cutoff. Just tried this before. So you just go for him. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Let's do it the old fashioned way. Let's back up on it. Okay. I feel like I should send that to the plus five as well, so that's on a -1.4. There you go. Yeah. Hats there. Put the hats there, my ass. Let's have a look at some loops. Just get kind of a little cheeky little vocal loop in here. Might work, might not. Let's have a look. Let's have a cheeky gander. This will take a minute or two to load. So really a lot of it is just about trial and error. Like, you never know what's going to sound good. You never know what's going to sound bad. But until you just test it out, see what sounds good. Like, there's no harm in doing this. Nowadays, if you make a mistake, all you got to do is hit Apple Z. And it undoes it. Like, obviously back in the day, you'd have your reels of tape, and if you make a mistake, like one of my old tutors, my old mentor, Paul Bailey, he's an old guy from Abbey Road who used to record on tape. And he used to say, if they made a mistake back then, you wouldn't undo it and chop it up. You had to cut the tape. So it's a bit better nowadays. Now you get these digital audio workstations, which are pretty cool. So let's find vocal sample. Thinking. So there's a lot here, there's 1,700, so it's, I think it's cheerful. Let's have an urban. Here we go. Right, let's get the loop going. Baby, 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 baby. Yes, okay, we've got a few going on here. Put the separate tracks. I think we can do some of this. So this one, not for now, mute that. Stick it in over here for now. These two, I think we can make it work. Let's have a little gander.
Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. Won't you give me that beat.
As you can tell, the tempo is not correct. So we've got Tyson. Is it Tyson, is this one?
Yeah, it's like that, y'all. It's like that.
Ooh, won't you give me that beat back.
Which one is that? Seven, Tyson lyric 9, okay. Not Mike Tyson.
Ooh, okay. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me back, ooh.
17. A few things we could do here. One, I'm just gonna try this cheeky little maneuver. I says it's not far off, you know, so it's all right. So we click on that, all right. Time stretch, here we go. So time stretch, region to, time stretch, region, length to locate. So it should go beep. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I can do it. Right, now it should be.
Ooh, won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. Won't you give me that beat
back. So we got that. I'll have to put that pitch, it sounds a bit. So it's, try pitch correction, get a bit of auto-tune, see what that sounds like.
Ooh, won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh. Won't you give me that beat back, ooh.
Won't you give me that beat back, ooh?
Won't you give me that beat back, ooh?
Won't you give me that beat back, ooh? Won't you give me that beat back, ooh? Won't you give me that beat back, ooh? Won't you give me that beat back, ooh? Won't you give me that,
Give me that. We don't just do normal, we get the warped. Let's try a drone. This is the, yeah, stuff I like. Similar kind of thing, similar kind of thing to the other lyric. So we've got that one going. I think that can work. Sounds pretty spacey, liking the sound of it. And this sounds so different from that original drum beat we did at the start. Do you know what I mean? We just check the cameras. Yeah, cool. All right. So, Darcy over here. Darcy. Right. Similar kind of thing. Right. Just not the right tempo. So, what was it? Edit. Yeah. Edit. Time stretch. Region to locators. Bajom. Yeah, yeah, convert. That should be.
Ooh, yeah, yeah. Oh, baby.
Mm. Let's go on the beat.
Ooh, yeah, yeah. Oh, baby.
I'm going to chop this up manually as I can. Nice hiccups until it's live. So I want this to go, ooh, baby. So let's move this to.
Ooh, yeah, yeah. Oh, baby.
Ooh, oh, baby.
Ooh, oh, baby.
So that's going to be copied. All right. Second time, I don't want me that. I want... All right. Nope. Yeah. And the second time, I want this little cheeky thing. Turn on. So it's the first time, the second time, feeling this. Yeah. Then, let's just not leave it simple. I want. Some more advanced stuff going on. If it's correct, it might be nice.
Ooh, oh baby.
Let's try this delay, the similar kind of one. Let's see what we got.
Ooh, oh baby.
A couple problems with the cameras, but what basically done is copied that pattern over and created a bit of a breakdown. Now I've changed the bass line here to A flat, right? Where's it there? Yeah, and I added a little riser. It's got here it is, it has. So this riser here, yeah. Come on. It's been slow today, doesn't like me. Don't like the sun. So I've got a pitch shift on the riser, make it a bit more, a bit lower. And then put another drone reverb on that as well. So it sounds like this. This is the riser we got. Pretty cool there, huh? Yeah! So this is the original one. So it's riser synth. Spell that right? Fair five, yeah. And then you put the drone effect. Yeah, that adds a bit of... And also time stretched it to fit the space as well. And I added this little cheeky crash. It was just normal ksh, ksh, crash. Add a delay, so echo, and also put the drone on as well. Cool. So that's basically what's happened. Dragged it over, made my own arrangement. Okay, that's basically it. And now I've changed the drum beat a little bit, so it's got this little cheeky cowbell. And then I just typed in the cowbell pattern, you'll be able to see. Right, Right, let's continue. Hopefully the cameras are still gonna work. It's the thing with these cameras. Battery runs out now and again. All right, let's just hear it from the top, okay? I was just putting a bit of automating this. Make it sound a bit more interesting. I think we could put another vocal part. If we can get like a slightly longer vocal, it would be great. Problem with the cameras, let's hold on one sec. Right, we're back on. Let's just play from the breakdown. I think here we could have some kind of rap vocal if got any logic long enough. Let's type in rap. Maybe not. A vocal. And do it by beats. So you can see the song's slowly building up, it's getting there. Oh, that's interesting. That is cool, using that. That's the thing, you never know what you can, what you get when you're just looking for stuff, for the loops especially. So I want this to come in on the kicks on the beat. So this sounds like. To stop when the rest of them stop. Let's be here. Cut off completely. So it's like that. Yeah, that's cool. Anyway, where were we? Find our vocal. Have a search for the loops. See what you get. Might be something cool or something terrible. You never know until you start looking through them. Let me try voice. There we go. We've got some long stuff.
Listen to the beat and the funk, funky rhyme.
Just for a laugh. This is going in. See if we can make this work. I think, I don't know if it will, but if we can make that work. A little choral bit. Obviously we have to change all the chords. It could work, it might not, but we'll have a look. Let's see. Oh, nearly forgot you, Darcy. So drag all this stuff over. Okay. Where's the chorus gone? Chorus gone. Oops, sorry. So drag from here. Oh, we go. Down we go. And then let's try four bars, if that works. So in C minor, so let's juggle this around. Oh, it's done for us. So C minor. And then G minor will work. Then A flat would be good. Copy and paste it at 41. Where we got? Split that. Copy this over. Right, let's see what this sounds like. Ignore that. Yeah, it needs to be half time. That's double speed of the chords, didn't realize. So we need to move this all over. Thank you. Keep that G going, actually. It might sound nice to be a 7th for the A flat. Might sound pretty cool. So this is going to be 4 because that's actually double. So this goes all the way to the end. So let's see what this sounds like. In other words, warp it. It doesn't have to be all clean cut like this. Just let me move this stuff out of the way for a bit. Oh. Yeah, in my opinion, it's all about the arrangement. Like, as long as the arrangement sounds good. I like that little pad we had to start with. Bring this in here. Flat. That works. A C. Let's have a C. Roll in a C. Nice. Yeah. So if we just change C down to B flat, give that a chop. This is a chop to D. Magical. Okay, let's check the cameras. Yeah, we're all cool. No more camera misfunction, hopefully. Go in, and it's quiet, it's too, you know, nice. I want to make it a bit more, you know, dirty. See what we've got a voice. What is the voice? Okay, let's leave that. Let's stick it to bus 5 as well. Because I'm liking this bus 5 stuff. Got it's 5 because of the snare. So if we make another bus exactly the same, bus 6, a bit weirder. Try a bit of chorus. Build the drums up a bit. We bring some hats in as well here. Then we bring the snare, the auxiliary for the snare here as well. And even the bass line. Let's bring him in at some point. Just to kind of get the mood going, you know? We bring this fella in, we bring Tyson as well. I like Tyson, he's a good lad. Right, cool, so let's see what it sounds like. I think we're getting somewhere. Then let's chop this up and just use one half. It's a C minor, which will work with A flat, be fine. Seventh. So we can just get that going. But obviously we don't want the G in there. So we just use, to there. Just repeat that, that'd be nice. Split by player head. Yeah, split. Split by player head. Split, yeah. Okay, so we've got this bit going here, this bit going here. Glue it, so it's a bit easier to move around. Recolor it. Same with this one, glue it, color it. See what this sounds like. Maybe just go back to the agent pluck riffs. Then bring the whole out in again. That can be a nice little ending. Keep going. So how long was this? Let's have a look. About 3 minutes. Oh, nearly 4 minutes. Okay. Let's play it from the start and see what we got. Not there. That can come in there. Yeah. Yeah, so it feels like it needs to be like 2/3 of the way in, not just there. Not just there. Oh, death wheel, there we go. Now it's just a bit of mixing, arrangement. But it's not the kick, here's the kick. Instead of dragging the back forward, obviously the forward's more small, you can just drag forward to here, right, like so, then upper layer, select all, drag to the side, there you go, 1, 2, 3, death wheel, boom. So now it's just, let's say the bulk of the song's kind of made, the vibe's there, it's just kind of arranging and just get it to sound good. If I had more time to work on this, I'd probably put more kind of harmonic structure, more harmonic section. So maybe some more chords, make it a bit more interesting, still keep stuff going. But the main writing's here, like as you can see, started off with a drum beat. It's kind of a funky drum beat. Then the bass line, there was one bit of the bass line that I liked at the end, and that became the kind of hook of the song. And it's just building from that. And if you listen to the very start of this video, that original funky drum beat I came up with doesn't sound anything like this at all. It's about keeping on building, keep going. The range, arrange, arrange. You want to put yourself in the listener's shoes and think what would they want to be feeling right now. For me, this is more of a trancey dance song, so I want the listener to kind of sit back and relax and just feel the music. So it's all about the listener, really. What's the listener's experience? And what is this piece of music for? And yeah, just keep writing, keep arranging. It's good always to come back to it another day and listen to it. because it will sound completely different to on the day. Because now me listening to this, if I come back and listen to this tomorrow, it'll sound so much different. I think your ears just get used to the certain sound, and when you kind of get away from this producing and into the real world and come back, your ears are kind of shocked. And yeah, but it's getting there though. I think you should hopefully get a grasp of how to actually do songwriting and the process of actually making the song. It's not all swift, it's not all easy, there's lots of mistakes, lots of errors. But as long as you keep building, keep going, you can make a song that's from scratch with no ideas. Like when I came to this, I had zero ideas about the song. I did that purposely because I didn't want to have any preconceived song ideas that would kind of change the process of songwriting. Because a lot of time you just open up Logic Pro, you just get writing and you just see what happens. That can be some of the best songs ever. Just from like spontaneity, really, and just people just playing songs, making music, and seeing what happens at the end of the day. So yeah, that's basically it. I hope you do the same with your own music. Just go for it. Trial and error is a lot of it. Learn the basics from this course, so you know how to actually put MIDI, put audio together, do some of the effects, do a bit of mixing. This song hasn't been mixed yet, but just use your ear. And just do what you think feels right, what sounds good. Keep on going. That's basically it. But thanks for watching this video. Just have one last quick listen, and then we're all good to go. Okay, so Will of Death's gone. So where up to so far? I'd say it's about 50% done. A lot of mixing you could do as well. Improve the sounds, EQ it all, pan it all. Just make it sound a bit bigger, really, a bit better. Let's just have a listen from the start. And we might do a few more tweaks as well. Thank you. Okay, I want to get this synth part going here. There. This is basically the main kind of arrangement of the song, the main written part. But yeah, there's a lot more I can still do. I can still spend a lot more time on that. Add a new section. I'd probably put a live vocal in myself as well. EQ it all, compress the parts. Just mix it really, just make sure it sounds good. And just keep it going. But this, I'd say, is the main bulk of the song. It's like a nice little cheeky 4-minute piece. I'd say I'm happy with this for now. There's still like a lot of work that could be done, but for this purpose of the video, I think it's great. So just keep on writing, keep on going, and just see what it sounds like. And always remember to save all the time. If your computer's on its last legs, like this one is, you can upgrade the RAM, which I've done before. But yeah, just keep going. I'm gonna bounce this now. I'm gonna bounce this MP3, 320 bit, just so we can hear what it sounds like. Demo song. I'm gonna save it to my hard drive. Yeah. So the thing is, you never really know what you might come up with. Like I said before, I had no idea what I was gonna write. It's all just off the top of my head, really. Just keep on going. But I have been doing songwriting and production for many, many years. So you just practice, keep on going, and experiment with new ideas. Don't just keep with the same presets, the same sounds. Always think of ways of pushing the boundaries. How can I make this different? How can I make this stand out? And just keep writing and keep experimenting. So you all know the basics now. If you follow the course and you're up to this point, you should know all know the basics on Logic Pro 10, which is the crucial part. If you don't know the basics, you can't experiment. You can't, because you can say experiment and see what happens, but if you don't know actually how to set up the recording, how to get stuff going, what stuff actually means, you're going to struggle. But once you've set it up, just do what I've been doing now. Think of ideas, write songs, mess around, experiment, and just come up with some cool song ideas. It'd be great for you guys to send me any of your songs. I'll have a quick listen, and be nice to get to hear some feedback from you lot. And that's basically it. Let's just have one more play of the song once it's bounced down, that we can hear what it's like on QuickTime, iTunes, VLC player. Whatever you want, really. MP3 isn't as high quality, but 320-bit is still fine. Like, if you listen to music in nightclubs, it's 320-bit normally as an MP3. So it's kind of the standard in the nightlife scene. Obviously, if you listen to a CD, it's high quality, but for tracks online, it doesn't need to be amazing. But yeah, as long as it sounds good, you get your ideas, keep on being creative, keep on going. You will get some good music. You just need to, get going. Make sure you've got your own setup. Try and get a little MIDI controller if possible. If you haven't, you can use musical typing. You can still do loads of stuff. Like when I've been traveling before, I've used a little mini micro MIDI controller, or I've just used musical typing. I've written loads of songs in musical typing. So you don't necessarily have to have a physical keyboard for you to play in. There's still loads of stuff you can actually do. But yeah, let's get the song. Have one last lesson. It's just bounced now. And hope you guys like some of the steps I've gone through. I hope you've realised it's not all shiny and perfect. There's a lot of mistakes to be made writing music, but as long as the song sounds good, that's all that matters. So let's just get this up. And we can have one last listen to the song. It's just a quick demo song, but it's only taken a few hours really, which is relatively short for songwriting in my opinion. Let's just hear what it sounds like. Oh, One thing I just noticed is the distortion on there. Ooh, that is appalling. Something I have to do. So if I hear any peaks like that that aren't meant to be there, I have to change it. So I wonder what it's doing it, to be fair. So it's happening on here, this part. Ooh, baby. Ooh. Maybe it's just peaking. See what it sounds like, volume down. I think it's to do with the reverb. Maybe turn the down a little bit, add a bit more dry. Hopefully that should get rid of it. Just bounce this down once more. Replace what it was called. We're all good to go. See, it's been quite a long video, but hopefully you've got to grips with the actual songwriting process now. You've seen step by step exactly what I've done and how to do it. And yeah, hopefully you could learn a few tips, a few hints. Anything that I might have gone through a little bit too quickly, when we can go back to the actual core modules of the product and have a look at what I do step by step on the screen. Obviously, this is more of an improvised video, purposely, so you guys can see on the fly what I actually do, rather than more of a structured step-by-step guide like the main product, which is great for you guys who want to learn the product. But when you want to see, like, in action, like in field, what I'm actually doing in the studio, you can see my kind of production process and how I actually do it. Yeah, so keep on building. There is other ways. You don't have to necessarily follow my structure. I know a lot of people that set goals exactly what they want to do in the song, so they want to know what it's going to sound like beforehand, which is great if you're writing for a specification. So if you're writing for, I don't know, writing library music or for a project or a collaboration, and you need a certain type of song to sound a certain way, which is fantastic. But if you want to write more free music just for your own personal satisfaction, or your own songs, your own music, I think it's great just to kind of dive right in and just do whatever really, as long as it sounds good, keep on expanding. But don't just rely on yourself. But this is from years and years of working with people and get little sneaky hints and tips from people. So always try and contact as many people as possible. So get hold of your friends who produce, even people online, people in your area, just message them and ask them if you want to get together and collaborate. Because that is the best way, really. When it's just you, you haven't really got anyone to ping off. Obviously, you can bounce ideas from the computer and from different effects and stuff, but when you've got another person there who can tell you give you some input, really, can tell you what they think, and you for them as well, because you can kind of weave their creative ideas into your own opinion, which is fantastic, really. So try and find people in your area, just collaborate, get together, write. The thing is, a lot of your stuff isn't going to be like the song or the hit singles or whatnot. You need to just keep writing, write, and then one great song might come out of that. It's like a lot of albums, really. You don't normally have single after single after single. You get a lot of filler tracks, but sometimes they're the nicest ones to listen to. Just because they're not singles doesn't necessarily mean they're not the best songs. But anyway, let's have one quick listen to this. Now I've just changed part of the track, just to get rid of that peaking of the vocals. The peaking kind of really annoyed me, so just little tweaks like that. When you listen back, I didn't realize that in the mix, but as soon as I bounced and listened back, it stood out. A good thing to do is listen to the bounce as well, because if you listen to the actual project, the arrangement, well, I spend a lot of time looking at the different parts, looking at the section, visualizing the music rather than just listening to it. So now I've got the bounce, let's sit back and have a quick listen. I hope you enjoy it. Oh, So yeah, there's still a lot of work to be done in that track, but as you can hear, the main backbones, the main core of the track's actually there. So when you get to this stage, you know, it's all about arrangement, mixing, final tweaks, crossing the T's, dotting the I's, and you'll be able to get your music done, mix, send it off, and enjoy making music.